Alright, we're back with more Rain-Slick Precipice of Darkness, Episode 3. Last time, I visited the Colosseum, and what did I get for it? Some equipment, and some cash. One thing we got is the Annihilator. It deals a set amount of damage to all enemies. The amp boosts it, but it's not exactly a lot. Anyways, let's get back to the story at hand. This is another Taiko entirely. The scholar is on leave. This other Bray is of more ancient lineage. He delivers a kick from the ball of his foot to the door's most tender realms, and it yields. Wow, I didn't know he had it in him. Hey there, Hark. Hark scrambles, seizing up a stone mask from the desk and placing it over his own face. He begins to speak, the stone mouth moving in perfect time.
Hence, thing! To what plays below where liars and their long knives?
Are you serious? Knock it off! Send me to what? I was never going anywhere else! Are you the dumbest cult ever? Is there somebody keeping track of this? Because you should have saved some room for the trophy! It's like, you get yourself a god, you cut him up, and then you keep all the parts in the same town? And not say, stick one at the bottom of the ocean, another buried in the deepest part of the wildest rainforest, another locked up and involved in a Himalayan monastery, and the last one in the new release's shelf at the local children's bookstore? Children's bookstore? I wouldn't look there. So, where is it, Hark? Euripides' Hark does not answer. It's not me you have to worry about, idiot. I'm not stealing these stupid things. I didn't even know about them until you rolled me up in all your dumb crap. If you had called me even 1 hour earlier, we'd be 3 to 4 now. Where is the last painting? Euripides' Hark does not answer. Fine, there's more than one way to skin a cat. It stands to reason, though, that all of them involve skin. What? All of them involve cat skinning.
Had to do it the hard way, didn't you, Hark?
This guy will be easy to beat. See?
The final piece, the very face of the god, lies in the temple below us. The temple to man.
See, was that so hard? Euripides' Hark is no more. Apparently, it was very hard in his organs. That hole in the back must lead to this man temple of theirs. Man temple. The sequel to Man Cave. If that were true, then, whoa. You gotta wonder what they've got in there. Be ready, the whole place is going to be buzzing like an anthill. An especially crazy, holy subterranean, deeply occult anthill. There's a lot of skulls in here, too. Is that the Deep Crow? Is that a Deep Crow? I wish it were a Deep Crow. It's a deeper crow, though. Big difference. How big of a difference are we talking? When Deep Crows talk to their therapists, it's generally about their fear of deeper crows. Great. Maria, let me tell you something that will be a comfort to you. Yes, please. At least I can only kill you once. Large stat bonus for all allies. Ooh, nice.
Down deep in the guts of the world, it grows them big.
It grows what big? The carrots? The potatoes? The corn? Man, if it was big corn. Ooh, that would be a lot. Anyways, let's buff Gabe. Why? He can really give the sneaker crow quite a beating. Let's see. Bootstraps. 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 Oh, that's not nice. Anyways. How about that, huh? Let's see. Give Gabe more energite.
it's not radioactive. If it were, you'd be glowing green by now.
Pontificatus. More speed. More magic. Euripides Hark again? Did he have clones? Team member aspect the giant skull. There's a lot of enthusiasm there. Wouldn't this terrifying heck portrait look great above the dark mantle? It's so big. They'll be dead in a moment. But since Ichor doesn't affect them all. Magic plus 40 to all allies. If only that were effective. Unfortunately, it's not exactly effective. And they're resistant. Well, it's a good thing we have annihilators. Alright, she's got an amp on her. Or some sort. Yes, it deals 1500 base. But it does more when it's amplified. Must be the Phazon. The Melcora. Artemis stands on its side of your handle. How old could this weapon be? I wonder. Slower, I'm afraid. I'll stick with the Phazon. Resinest and Rattler. Man, Resinests are always doing crap like this. Don't worry, these manacles are fur-lined. Fur-lined manacles. I wonder where they got those. I really do. Cause that's like something. You know? Having all that there, it's gotta be something. A resonating apple bomb. Anarchism? Okay, now to beat these. They're associate cultists. An acolyte with upper management written all over him, in blood. Does he do that on his resume? I don't know. It's kind of morbid though. If you put him in blood in your resume, you gotta wonder who would accept that. I probably have an idea. Maybe it's the corporate people. I mean, sure, when you devote your life to them, it's like, do it in blood or something. Or maybe it's a cult company. They have those, don't they? I mean, there was a cult company in 6 Days of Sacrifice. You know that one. I must claim those terrifying pants for my own! Mrs. Scary Pants, whoever he is, seems very surprised. Enemy targets ally with lowest defense. He's not wearing any pants! He looks like he's wearing a diaper! It's not just the pants, though. He's scary all over. Yeah, I think it's still a diaper. I wonder who's the lowest defense. Tycho. Should have guessed that one. Ah well. Don't have to worry too much about it. He can always dispense some health. Going to attack the one with the weakest defense, wouldn't they have abilities focused on that? Eh. Oh well. I didn't notice it, but it looks like Mr. Scary Pants is wearing a baseball cap. I'm not fond of baseball caps. I prefer nice hats. Baseball caps are a dime a dozen. Sure, the quality and rarity may depend on what they are, but still, dime a dozen. You can get them at the nearby corner store for probably $5. Well, I don't think it'll be $5, but still. Devil guy in a giant skull. He's not the devil, no, but he knows the devil. Gee, thanks. I think I'll pass on the... Well, asking him about that. Stun Gate. Not bad. Not bad enemies. Not great, but not bad. Why do I tell you that it's not great? Because, well, you'll be dead soon enough. Let's see. First, I want to get rid of those skulls. As soon as I get rid of them. Here we go. Lizard. Gabe can punch the devil guy. What? He was running to punch devils. Now we did. Talismans, delicious MP drops for fresh breath and psychic vigor. More of those. I don't know if I really want to. Let's see. Yeah, I think these guys will be dead soon enough. Let's give Jim some energize. Or I don't need to. Gabe can just punch them all to death. Climbing the corporate cultist ladder. Large stat bonus for all enemies. bet it doesn't help that they fell off the top. Or someone pushed the ladder.
Los Manos!
Oh sure, I bet these cured ashen handskins are totally safe. Boosts magic, but Gabe's not a magic person, he's a fists person. The wrestler. He's got this crazy move where he kinda... Well, you see. I don't think I want to see. I think I'd rather unsee it. If there is one. Punching a stone statue with your fists. Yeah, great idea. Still, it worked. Alright, so interject for Jim. Wizard. Seasickness. Okay. Claustrophobia. Takes care of those. More levels. Sky cultists? Hang on! Okay, sorry about that. Something came up and I had to take care of something. Alright, where were we? Sky cultists. The sky's the limit with this guy. Literally, though. A sky cultist, and yet this is a temple of man. Yeah, I see no problem there. Other than the fact that this sky cultist has no head. I mean, seriously. If it's a temple dedicated to man, why aren't all the cultists? Well, you know, humans. Well, I guess then you have a lot of cult objects, because I'm sure the sky cultist is not something you would have in a book. Let's see, Highlighter and wonder if he can get it off before Gabe punches them. Obviously not. Still enough. Kinda looks like Frankenstein. Cram Scroll, start battle 6 MP. MP is not gained each turn. Good thing I have Energite, Professor Necrodead, and Chattermouth. He didn't take 8 years of necromancy so you could call him Mister. Personally, I'd rather be a Lich than a... make a... half-zombie, half-human. It's cool and everything, but I think I prefer my faces with skin? Anyways... He has become the fists of God. They hurt too. Man. They hurt. Let's see. Alright, let's just use Yeah, let's use that.
Huh. Fire hurts. Them.
Aura does not have any all-enemy spells. Skills. Except for the garden. Pulverize, Master's Thesis, Bottled Rage, Magnifying Glass, Fast Switch, Imitation Crab, Hopocalypse. It's the Hopocalypse! Run for your life! All these hobos are coming out of nowhere! They're raining from the sky! And I think I got some bad perfume. Elbow Grease and Terror Stigma. I think I knew that guy back at the academy. Really? Did he try and kill you at the academy too? Yes, but he was still working on his undergraduate degree back then, so he didn't do a very good job at it. Which is to say, you survived? Precisely.
Whoop. Oh well. We can take them on.
Ultra massive attack!
9 MP though.
Honestly, that's a lot. What does my massive holy magic? And Paco's massive effect, physical and magical.
Medium dark magic all every turn. Woo woo! I think I'm gonna give him talismans.
It's magic stuff! Full of magic and stuff.
Kinda expect that to happen. All or nothing, apocalypse. Smell the roses.
Oh, it's right there.
Urn, halfway house royal organs, their quiet power remains. A lot better. Let's see, all level 40. Let's see, I want to look at strength bonus when HP is low. All or nothing, here we go. Massive attack, drop to 1 HP. I don't know. Pulverize or all or nothing. Maybe I'll use the all or nothing for something. Increases the strength of other prophecies. Incomplete prophecy as Earth All. Reduces elemental resist, stacks. Oh, that's nice. Defensive magic resist up all. Yeah. That's something I could use. May insta-kill. We all know how May insta-kills work. Come more frequently. That's nice. Boost speed all. Alright, first things first. Give him some talismans. Why is he not wearing the heart signet? Anyways. Thank you.
Let's see. I want to use claustrophobia.
It's the Annihilators!
Let's see... Elbow Grease.
I eat pain.
R Scorpions. The R stats are Robert. Robert Scorpion? I guess it works. How much health do these guys have? A lot. Let's see. More Energite.
Falcon Punch.
May as well use that. $18,000 on normal people. I wonder how much more powerful it is on others. The Omnibus. A wicked eldritch firearm with optional Grimoire mount. I can read two books! I can read two books! I can read and shoot. I can read two books and shoot. Yeah, I like that. I mean, seriously. A gun with a book holder on it. And it stays level. The Resinus. Man, Resinus are always doing crap like this. Crap like what? Oh, it's those guys. Anyways, magnifying glass. Oh, they're weak to holy magic, that's for sure. Nope. Frozen Skulls. Science Pills. The stat-boosting power of science. In convenient pill form. I don't know what it does. Science Pills. Plus 30 to all stats. Meh. There's a treasure chest. Oh, he's not an enemy. Numbers! Math!
this guy's gone loco. Lost his mind. Lost his marbles. Lost his mind and his marbles. Those marbles are rare. Scorpion with all or nothing. Meh. Okay, we'll live. I have enough potions. Let's see. I want to. I want him to punch that guy and. Okay, punch that guy. There we go. See how great that was. Man, that attack is slow. Oh well. It's good enough. $50,000! Yay! Good stuff. Another deeper crow? Okay. I guess there's more deeper crows than there are deep crows. I don't wonder about that. From beneath his collar, you can see something dancing beneath Tycho's shirt. It begins to warble, softly. Oh no. He draws it out on a leather strap, a small flat disc of rose quartz. The warble increases in volume until the stone coin pulverizes. No, no, not now! We need to go to the periphery, right now! But why? There's no time. But Delsol's found the last painting. It won't matter if we don't go now! How many chances do you think we're going to get at this? Tycho fishes out a glass bead, hurling it against the wall. A spark flares, growing, until it becomes a blue disk. Through it, you can see New Arcadia. To the north, the cavern beckons. Now would be an excellent time for you to save your game. Which is probably what I'll do right now. We're nearing the end, guys. We're nearing the end. We can head up and finish the job, or head in here and go to the periphery. Honestly, canonically, we're going to the periphery. That's it for this episode. So until then, this is Melcadrien, and this has been the Rainstick Precipice of Darkness, Episode 3. I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day, and happy gaming.